You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for Happy Hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
It's radio you can see. Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, coming your way shortly.
You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for Happy Hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
It's radio you can see. Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, coming your way shortly.
You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for Happy Hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
It's radio you can see. Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, coming your way shortly.
You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for Happy Hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
It's radio you can see. Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, coming your way shortly.
You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for Happy Hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
It's radio you can see. Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, coming your way shortly.
You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for Happy Hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
It's radio you can see. Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, coming your way shortly.
You're just moments away from Happy Hour, the original video show in the Radio Smuliverse.
You've got time to grab yourself a drink and then settle in for happy hour. The show will begin momentarily.
The video portion of Happy Hour is best experienced on Twitch. Look for the links in the Synergy chat room.
Hey guys, this is Lex, and I just wanted to take a moment to remind you that Happy Hour is an adult-themed show. It takes place in a bar setting. We talk about drinking, we occasionally play drinking games. We play all kinds of music, and that may include music with adult themes or foul language. So please enjoy your beverages and your music responsibly. Hope you guys have a great time tonight. Rock on.
First time in a bar? I'll show you around.
There'll always be guys wanting a drink.
I'd go easy on that liquor if I were you.
Hey, look, mister. We save hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast.
Everybody who's anybody drinks.
I picked a hell of a day to quit drinking.
My advice to you is to start drinking heavily.
I've been doing some thinking drinking, Bunny.
I want you to have a drink.
Don't make me feel like I'm drinking alone, ma'am.
Tasty. What is this we're drinking?
What I need's a couple of good stiff drinks. How about you, Angel? You want a drink?
They may be drinkers, Robin, but they're also human beings.
Well, ain't you going to drink with me?
They look thirsty! Well, let's give them something to drink!
Heads up!
Woo-hoo!
Heads up!
Woo-hoo!
It's another one, and another one. Yeek, yeek!
Woo-hoo!
Why you all in my ear, talking a whole bunch of shit that I ain't trying to hear? Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Yeek, yeek!
Woo-hoo!
I ain't playing around, make one false move, I'll take you down. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Woo! Come on, don't! Get swung on, it's the knick-knack, paddywhack, still riding Cadillacs, family out the street, make my homies put the baggies back, still action-packed,
yep.
Still stacking plaques,
yep.
And dough, I keep it flipping like acrobats, that's why I pack a Mac, that'll crack them back, cause on my waist is more heat than the Shaq attack.
But I ain't speaking about ballin', just thinking about brawlin', till y'all start ballin', we all in together now, birds of a feather now, just bought a plane so we changing the weather now. So put your brakes on, caps, put your capes on, or knock off your block, get dropped, and have your face flown. Cause I'll prove it, scratch off the music, like, hey, little stupid, don't make me lose
yeek,
it.
Yeek, yeek! Why you all in my ear, talking a whole bunch of shit that I ain't trying to hear? Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Yeek, yeek!
Whoop, whoop!
I ain't playing around, make one false move, I'll take you down. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
I came, I saw, I hit him right dead in the jaw. I came, I saw, I hit him right dead in the jaw. I came, I saw, I hit him right dead in the jaw. I came, I saw, I hit him right dead in the jaw.
See, I caught him with the right hook, caught him with a jab, caught him with an uppercut. Kicked him in his ass, sent us on his way, cause I ain't for that talk. Ain't no trips to the county, I ain't for that walk. We split like two pins at the end of the lane. We'll knock out your spotlight and put an end to your fame. Put a DTP pendant at the end of your chain. Then put the booty of a swisher at the end of a flame. Yeek, yeek, whoop, whoop.
Why you all in my ear, talking whole bunch of shit I ain't trying to hear? Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Yeek, yeek. I ain't playing around, make one false move, I'll take you down. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Hey, you want what with me? I'm gonna tell you one time, don't fuck with me. Get down.
Cause I ain't got nothing to lose. I'm having a bad day, don't make me take it out on you. You want what with me? I'ma tell you one time, don't fuck with me.
Get down, cause I ain't got nothing to lose, and I'm having a bad day. Don't make me take me naked out on you, cause I don't wanna do that. I wanna have a good time and enjoy my jack. Sit back and watch the women get drunk as hell, so I'm gonna wake up in the morning with a story to tell. I know it's been a little while since I've been out the house, but now here you wanna stand around running your mouth. I can't hear nothing you saying, no spitting, so what's up? Don't you see we in the club, man? Shut the fuck up! Yeek, yeek, whoop, whoop!
Why you all in my ear, talking a whole bunch of shit that I ain't trying to hear? Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Yeek, yeek, whoop, whoop. I ain't playing around, make one false move, I'll take you down. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that. We in the red light district. We in the red light district. Woo! We in the red light district. We in the red light district. Woo! We in the red light district. Woo! The red light district. Woo! The red light district. Woo! The red light district. We in the red light district.
Serving up happy hour with Lex and Tony. Hey, remember to tip your bartenders and waitresses.
Hey guys, welcome to happy hour with Lex and Tony. It is a fabulous Friday night, and Tony, you're going to have to explain what we just saw there, because there's some interesting facts and interesting visuals.
I'm sure many of you might be saying, you know, I've heard that song somewhere in the last couple weeks. The reason it's an earworm for me, it's Ludacris from, you know, back from probably 20 years ago. Name of the song is Get Back, obviously. But there's a Nissan commercial that plays probably two or even three times a game during March Madness, both men's and women's March Madness.
There's no way it had those lyrics.
Only a bit of the song play.
Okay.
The funny thing is, I'm sure a lot of people, maybe a little older, not familiar with Ludacris, are watching. It's like, well, that's a catchy tune. I'm going to Google that. You know, the song is in Nissan commercial. Oh, Ludacris, Get Back. I'll check that out on YouTube. And then they're like, oops. What?
Yeah, you go.
Yeah, the Nissan commercial doesn't have any of the swear words, but of course, Lex and Tony, you know, we don't pull any punches, man. We don't sing the cleaned up version of anything. So, you know, hopefully we did play the disclaimer, the adult language thing before the show, right?
Always, yeah.
Okay, I just wanted to make
always,
sure.
Yeah.
But yeah, that is a catchy tune. And like I said, if you're watching March Madness, and for those of you maybe in, I don't know, Germany that don't know what March Madness is, that is the NCAA, the college basketball tournament that goes on in March and extends in a little bit into April every year. It's a big deal, men's and women's. Women's is an even bigger deal than ever before, thanks to, whoop, whoop, Caitlin Clark. By the way, game's on tonight at 8:30.
Oh,
Lex,
boy. Might
have to wrap this up a little early.
Yeah. Tony, if Tony's not paying a lot of attention to the show, you all know why. He'll be like, oh, wait a minute, Caitlin just what?
But no, that song is used in a Nissan. The commercial is actually pretty funny. I think it's like in a fitness club, and there's a girl behind like the snack bar counter, and some dude orders like a kale smoothie or something, and then she hops up on the counter and does like a butt spin and says, you know, I'm out of here, it's game time. And then the song starts and she rides around in a Nissan Rogue with mascots of the various schools, and they joyride around the fitness complex, and then they head out the dough, to, I don't know where they're going, but it's a good commercial. But here's the thing, man, like I said, it is on two and three times every game during March Madness, and there's 67 games in the men's tournament, I think 63 games in the women's tournament. So here's what I'm thinking. You can't just like grab a song and put it in a commercial. You have to pay royalties.
Oh yeah.
You know, there's like there's ASCAP and BMI are your music licensing, you know, companies. So, you know, and it's based on how many people hear, if you use a song for background, it's based on how many people get are exposed to it. So Ludacris is stacking fat cash these, you know, March Madness plays. So, yeah, I mean, he has like, you know, whoop, whoop. He's raking in the dough right now.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know how we can.
I want to know how many people actually knew the song.
I'm curious. I mean, I remember it, but I don't know if other people do. So Wigamondo says, nope.
Yeah. I'm looking back at the chat.
People know it, man.
I'm looking back at the chat. I don't think I've ever heard of Ludacris. But well, I've heard of it, but I never sang any of his songs. Don't know any of his songs. I never know any of the songs we sing. Lex is a big Ludacris fan. You know what? That's funny.
Lex didn't know this song, and what made it worse, the track we used, uploaded on Smule.
Yeah.
The lyrics, the timing was horrible. The lyrics were like way ahead of the music, so a lot of times, the lyrics were off the screen by the time by the time you had to sing them.
Yep.
So you know, good luck with that if you don't know the song.
I spent the whole afternoon on this one, man. And it was tough. Like, it wasn't so bad. I got through the music, like the vocal part, because I put it on Spotify and I pulled up the lyrics and I'm listening and doing a section at a time, and that was okay. But then when I had to go up and lip sync, and I'm like, oh my God. Because I, like you said, most of the time the lyrics are off. I don't have any lyrics to go by. I must have redone that thing. I don't know. I lost count how many times I redid it. The last time I almost had it, somebody texted me and I forgot to set up my Do Not Disturb, and I couldn't read what lyrics I could have read. So I had to do it one more time. And after that, I'm like, I am done. I was so not happy with this song. So that was why I was pissed.
Now, Lex was a trooper on this, seriously. Because you know, I mean, it's funny. The last, like, what, month or 6 weeks, I've dragged Lex into Limp Bizkit break stuff. Kid Rock Cowboy. What else? There's something else that was like a harsh rappy type thing. Well, this. So I don't know, Lex. Maybe next
others,
week.
Maybe
next week we'll do DMX. X won't give it to you. Anyway, I think it's time for Lex to pick the song next week. Whatever you want, I will do.
I am to the like one. You know, it's funny. I thought about that today. I'm like, Tony's going to feel bad and he's going to be nice and he's going to offer to let me choose the song. And I realized that if you didn't choose these songs, I would have no clue what to choose. Nothing I chose would be any fun. I don't think that is ever going to work very well. Like once or twice, I picked an interesting song that worked, but it was kind of like a surprise, like unexpected happening. So I don't know. We'll see.
I mean, I do know, like if you're unfamiliar with Ludacris, I mean, there's basically two songs. The one you just heard, but the bigger hit would be, you know, Move, Bitch, Get Out the Way.
I don't know that one either.
Evidently, Ludacris has a problem with people invading his personal space.
That seems like, you know,
the Move, Bitch, and the Get Back. Yeah. They could have used him like during COVID for like the social distancing. Move, Bitch, Get Out the Way. 6 foot away, Bitch, Get Out the Way.
That would have been perfect. Yeah. Why didn't we think of that? Damn. I don't know.
But
I do not picture Tony singing a Sweet Carpenter song with me. Denise, what are you thinking?
I don't even know any Carpenters other than We've Only Just Begun. I think they sang that at my graduation.
I don't see anybody wanting to hear us sing that. That's just me.
You know, I will say this week it was either going to be that song because it's all over March Madness, or I also thought about Total Eclipse of the Heart. Hello, Eclipse on
that
Monday.
That would have been good. Yeah. Why didn't you choose
that's
that one?
Five I know and a half song. Minutes long.
It's Dude, that was four and a half minutes of I've never heard of
no,
it
that's
before.
That's true. You know, most like rap songs.
And that
songs
was the short version.
Yeah, like Ludacris kind of, you know.
I just wanted to get
over and above on that.
I wanted to follow the video, the original video, and get the big arms and do the big, like, because if you've seen the video, every like scene, his arms are like bigger and bigger and bulky. Like he's eating his spinach. He looks like Popeye. Yeah, it's so funny. By the end, he can barely move them. He's like, oh, I put them on.
He's in a bathroom, like at a bar or something.
The start of it, yeah.
Like bothering him, hence the. You know, then the get back starts, and he's like, you know, kind of kicking the dude's ass. So yeah, that's That's ludicrous in a nutshell.
Yeah. And speaking of, I see Laura in the chat trying to pretend that she wasn't the one who probably texted me in the poor Laura. So I was, Laura will tell you, when I say that I was pissed, I'm like, Laura, what the hell are you doing? Quit texting me. I got to get this fucking thing done. It's not working. I was so mad. And she was so nice about it. So it was pretty funny. But thank you.
All right.
Laura,
now I tell you what.
For not hating
Laura,
me.
Maybe it was you. Maybe it wasn't. We'll never know.
It was Laura.
But
nobody else would have been nice enough to let me yell at them and just ignore me. So yeah. I appreciated that.
I'm going to tell you guys one thing. Number one, thanks for tuning in. This is Happy Hour, Lex and Tony. We do it every Friday. It's a video show, as you may or may not know. We have some new viewers here, so welcome.
Yes.
We have some new contributors here, so we'll get to those during the show. And again, it's a video show. We play any type of music, and quite frankly, the diversity tonight is impressive. I mean, we run the gamut. You know, every musical genre I think is represented tonight, short of Gregorian chants, and who knows, maybe we can find one. But, so thank you for always supporting the show, always sending your stuff in, because, you know, we do things a little differently. We don't have a submission room. We don't backlog, songs. Each week is a new submission week. We play everyone who submits.
Yep.
Now, granted, sometimes, like, you know, somebody submits something that somebody else, you know, like a duet and somebody else already submitted. You got to kind of work that out amongst yourselves. Again, always get consent. Whether you're sending songs to Happy Hour or you're trying a new sex position, always get consent.
Yeah.
We play everyone who submits, and it's usually about, you know, 25, 29 songs. They all kick ass. Thank you so much. We need to get this thing rolling. And I mentioned diversity of genres. Up here in the front row, we call it the pole position, like it's a NASCAR race. Front row Joes this week. We're taking it. We're taking it kind of goth, kind of metal, kind of dark. We're going to kick this thing off with Vexed Mama, Devil in Eye, a Slipknot song.
Where are they from again?
Yeah, Iowa. And that's going to be followed by a new contributor. I got to pronounce her name right. In a proper, like, German style.
Oh, good luck.
Kailis. Hopefully I got that right. I don't know why I had to, like, sound like, you know.
I don't know what that sounded like. That's awful.
But anyway.
It was better than my guess, because I was thinking Cialis, and I thought, you know, that just gave me a different image of stuff. You know, Cialis. I thought maybe.
Lex has been raiding my medicine cabinet.
Ay.
You know, if you have an erection for last more than 4 hours, enjoy it. Anyway, Vexed Mama, Kailis will follow. This is our front row Joe. We're going to rock out, kicking off the happy hour right now with Lex and Tony. Actually, with Vexed Mama, but Lex and Tony, we're your hosts, so you can.
Here we go.
Brother Jockey Rock Mix.
Let's go. Let's go.
Undo these chains, my friend. I'll show you the rage I've hidden. Perish the sacrament. swallow, but nothing's forgiving. You and I can't decide which of us was taken for granted. Make amends. Some of us are destined to be out tempting the Father. Where is your will, my friend? Insatiates never even bother. You and I, wrong or right, traded the life for the leverage. In between the lens and light, you are not what you say.
Is abandoned. Fool you called, I know what you've done. Sensation, deprivation. You should have burned with journal,
I'm tired of being what you want me to be. Feelings of faithless, my somberness surface. Don't know what you're expecting of me, but under the pressure of walking in your shoes.
Caught in the underdog, just caught in the underdog.
everything that you thought I would be has fallen apart right in front of you.
Hey guys, I was slow to hit the button because we were still talking about how cool that looked at the end.
Like seven
because it was the way the two screens. It was very cool. Wow, what? So that's a fantastic song. Not an easy song to sing. The mashup was fabulous. The vocals, the video, just absolutely incredible way to jump into Happy Hour. That was fantastic. Welcome. And I'm not even going to try to pronounce the name because I'll totally screw it up.
Kaelis, I believe. Like when you talk German, you just have to be like forceful. So like whatever you say, just, oh yeah, that must be right because he sounded forceful. Kaelis.
Yeah, I don't think that's how it works. And Vexy, holy cow, kicking it off with the Slipknot, Devil and I. I love that. What a great set. You know, I love that. Oh, nicely done, ladies.
Love the knot.
Yes.
Love you know the maggots.
Are you a maggot?
Yeah. So you know, again, if you're from Iowa, you love Slipknot and you love Caitlin Clark. That's like, you know, and pork tenderloins. That's another thing in Iowa. You know what a pork tenderloin is, Lex? It's pork tenderloin, but they beat it to death, like, so it's like super like thin and flat, and it's like this big, and then it's breaded and then deep fried, and they put it on a bun, and of course the bun's like this big and the tenderloin's like this big, and they put a couple pickles on it, and then you see it on Facebook, oh hey, the biggest pork tenderloin ever, it, you know, at Sonny's Cafe in West Des Moines. I don't know why it's an Iowa thing to like make pork tenderloins that are like 20 times bigger than the bun, but it is. So there,
that's,
you go.
Interesting. No, I mean, regular pork tenderloin, yes. Like that, no. So I have no idea.
Yeah, I think it's like the same pork, you know, like that rolled up, like cylindrical pork tenderloin. Just you slice it and then beat the shit out of it with like that little like meat masher
thing. I should have made one of those this afternoon. I was ready for it.
And you bread it, get the thing, deep fry it, and you know, it's like comical how it like hangs over like the plate, you know. That,
you have to get us a picture for later.
I think I will. But there you go. So there, Vexy, awesome job. Kaelis, awesome job. Now Kaelis is in Germany, and you know, much like Wigamondo, you know, we have the UK early play. We had to have a German early play, and I'm gonna, I have a name for that in German. I believe it's a. Fruisch Spiel. not to be confused with Vorspiel, which means foreplay in German. Although I guess we could go with Vorspiel.
I mostly know Vorsteiner and Gewürztraminer, but that's it. That's my German right there.
The only German I know is from like Hogan's Heroes.
Don't go there.
That's the only
Schnitzel is good.
But I love the language because it's so forceful. It's like, you know, it's just like all the words just sound like great. So, you know, there you go. So, Kaelis, welcome to Guten Tag der Happy Hour. Willkommen to Happy Hour.
Yes, there you go.
I think that's welcome to Happy Hour because we used that in a promo way
back. Oh, around the world.
Oktoberfest!
Yes. Or Oktoberfest. Yeah, it could have been either, but it's probably Oktoberfest. So, that would have made a lot more sense.
Great first set, girls. Now, okay. We're heading into the second set. Remember I said how diverse this was?
I just want to say that right now, the way we're pacing, we're going to be doing two sets an hour.
I'm going to freaking miss
so we
the
will
IOD.
Be done, but we'll be done I'll by be like tomorrow up. Morning at like 8 a.m.
I gotta snap this up. We played a set plus the show starts. Okay. We're going to go into the 2-minute offense right now. All right. Coming up next. I mentioned how diverse Happy Hour is tonight. And you know what? We got the country set coming up.
Nice.
Very early for the country set, I might
add. Where's that?
Merlita heads up a group song. Merlita, Casey, Sandy, Nicole, Mary, Leonor, Ashley, Jamie Lynn Spears. No, I don't know if Jamie Lynn Spears is involved or not. The two names go together. I Feel Lucky. Hello, Mary Chapin Carpenter. And then after that, remember I said country set. I got to find my hat. Wigamondo, UK early play country version, will follow up the girls on their group song. So stay tuned. Country set coming up next in the Happy Hour, Lex and Tony.
Against you, girl, get back in bed.
I feel lucky. I feel lucky, yeah.
No Professor Doom gonna stand in my way.
I feel lucky today.
Saying, girl, you better get back home.
I feel lucky. I feel lucky, yeah.
No tropical depression gonna steal my son away.
I feel lucky today.
Lucky tonight.
I feel lucky.
lucky, yeah.
Think I'll flip a coin, I'm a winner either way.
I feel lucky today.
For long enough, maybe you can show me how to love. Maybe going through the draws, you don't even have to do too much. You can tear me on with just a touch, baby. I look around and sunset is gone on empty. No one's around to judge me. I can't see clearly when you're gone. I said, ooh, I'm blinded by the lights. No, I can't sleep until I feel your touch. I said, ooh, I'm drowning in the night. Oh, when I'm like this, you're the one I trust. Running out of time, 'cause I can see the sunlight up the sky. So I hit the road and overdrive, baby. Sunset is cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can't see clearly when you're gone. And I said, ooh, I'm blinded by the lights. No, I can't sleep until I feel your touch. I said, ooh, I'm drowning in the night. Oh, when I'm like this, you're the one I trust.
I'm just walking by to let you know,
let
I can
you
never
know.
See it on the boat.
See it on the boat.
We'll never let you go this time.
I said, no, I can't sleep until I feel your touch. I said, ooh, I'm drowning in the night. Oh, when I'm like this, you're the one I trust.
Hey guys, so welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Yeehaw. Tony, you enjoyed that country set, didn't you?
I did. Now, of course, the group song, the ladies, with that I Feel Lucky, I recognize that song. Wigamondo's song, and by the way, ladies, great job. I mean, always hard to pull off a group song with that many people. Y'all look fabulous. Y'all sounded fabulous. So, you know, my hat's off to you, little fillies. Now, Wigamondo, I think it's a country version of maybe a rock song. I was getting that
it's a country version, so that suggests, yeah, that it's not a country
song.
Well,
Jonathan Layden said, well, you put a country spin on it. So if I know, Jonathan Layden knows like every obscure band, like, you know, known to mankind. So I don't know what band originally sang. No, Jonathan Layden puts me to shame, man.
Wigamondo saying it's pop, not rock. So okay. That may be the reason you're not as familiar.
I'm a Padawan compared to Jonathan Layden when it comes to the bands. He's got, man, like he he just knows. But all right, is it Tebby Minus? Is that what I'm reading? I was unsure. Now, what I do know is that Wigamano did a kick-ass job on it. And that, I love the country swing of the Wigamano.
He's got such unique, you know, we have a bunch of folks in the show. Everybody's got a unique voice and everything, but Wigamano has very recognizable vocals. So if I hear Wigamano sing, I almost always know that's Wigamano. Kind of like Crystal Catnip and some of the other folks in here who've got kind of like a unique timbre to their vocals, things like that. Very distinct voice. Timber. That's right, MTG.
Are you a lumberjack?
So great tune. And then, I mean, just to mention the ladies, totally decked out to the nines, all the glitter and glam. They just looked amazing.
Yeah, you guys looked great. Seriously,
they looked
man.
As good as they sounded, I will say. That was fun. A lot of fun to watch. You guys did a fabulous job with that.
All right. Now, Lex was warning me that we're pacing slow, so we're going to jump into the next set. Oh, my goodness. The next set, we're taking this back to the 70s, man.
Oh, boy. Yep.
This is like, you know, kind of like a disco fever. The first song, it's a group song. Weird and Wonderful. You might remember them from last week with the Lions tonight, where they're all animals.
Uh-huh.
Well, this time around, they've joined the Navy.
Oh,
hello, village people in the Navy. Oh, my God, I love this. That'll kick off our little Super 70s, dance party disco set. After that, let me get my glasses. I hate how I gotta lean in. There we go.
Leaning in is good in certain cases.
I'm the four-eyed cowboy. Actually, no, it's a dance set, so I gotta lose the hat. There we go.
You need the disco ball. That's what you need.
Teasing man and One Global Deluxe One Family will bring us. I saw Jump. I'm like, is it Van Halen Jump? Is it Jump Around? House of Pain? No. Pointer Sisters Jump.
Yep.
So hello, Pointer Sister Village people. They go together like peas and carrots. But Weird and Wonderful, kicking us off, group song.
Welcome back, guys.
Baby.
This is awesome.
Hot off the Lion Sleeps Tonight from last week. Here we go. By the way, they're all from Germany, and one is from, I believe, Scotland. So this is another Freuspiel. I don't even know if I pronounced that right. Anyway, let's kick it off. Here's Weird and Wonderful in the Navy.
Yeah, it's Navy time. Can you find pleasure? Search the world for treasure. Learn science, technology.
Where can you begin to make your dreams all come true? On the land or on the sea?
Where can you learn to fly, play in sports and skin that? Study oceanography.
Sang the further big band, sit in the grandstand when you team and doubles me.
In the Navy,
yes, you can sail the seven seas.
In the Navy,
yes, you can put your mind at ease.
In the Navy,
come on, the people make it time.
In the Navy,
can't you see we need a hand?
In the Navy,
come on, take the mother land.
In the Navy,
come on and join your fellow man.
In the Navy,
come on, the people make it time.
In the Navy.
You as a new recruit.
If you like adventure, don't you wait to enter. The recruiting office fast.
Don't you hesitate, there is no need to wait. Signing up your seaman fest.
Maybe you are too young to join up today, but don't you worry about a thing.
For I sure them will be always a good Navy, protecting the land and the sea.
In the Navy,
yes, you can sail the seven seas.
In the Navy,
yes, you can put your mind at ease.
In the Navy,
come on, all people
But I'm afraid of water. Hey, look, man. I get seasick even watching it on TV.
They want you.
Oh, my goodness.
They want you.
That's just too weird for me. What am I going to do in a submarine?
They want you. In the Navy.
Yes, you can tell the time to see.
In the Navy.
Yes, you can put your mind at ease.
In the Navy.
Come on, our people, make a stand.
In the Navy.
Weird and Wonderful.
Impromptu time.
Jump, jump for my love. Jump.
Impromptu.
Hey guys, welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. So, all right, we had this amazing, amazing group set right there. We kicked it off. Actually, both groups, I think, as a whole, are relatively new. Weird and Wonderful kicked off the set with just an amazing presentation of In the Navy. And we followed it up with One Global Deluxe family doing Jump. Now, I think, well, of course, we've had Teasing Man and Bear Cubs on the show. But as a group song, I don't think that we've ever featured them as a group, that One Global Deluxe, or is it maybe it's just called Global Deluxe with the one on either side. I'm not sure how they go. But wow, I mean, I mean, the vocals on that on Jump were incredible. The group songs are so tough to get that clean and crisp, and the blend and everything was just
big
fantastic.
Time. Yes.
You know, all the phrasing, everything was so cool. And In the Navy, again, like I loved how they had, I mean, the costumes, the moves, all the stuff. I mean,
awesome.
So good. Yeah, absolutely fantastic. So excited to have you guys back tonight on the show.
And you know, strangely enough, the U.S. Navy like green lit that village people like oh yeah, that'd be great, be good for recruiting. The U.S. Navy didn't realize like you know the whole don't ask, don't tell like thing about the village people. The village people were gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but you know that like the I don't think the Navy realized that. Now, of course, they're mostly German. In Weird and Wonderful. So I think, again, Hogan's Heroes, I think the German word for Navy is Bundesmarine. At least that's what it was in Hogan's Heroes. Now, maybe it's changed, you know, since the country's unified now. Remember, Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall. So they might have changed the name for a German. Maybe now it's Freundesmarine. I have no idea. But what I do know is that song was great. And the Pointer Sisters, oh my God, Bear Cubs. Wow. You guys just like knocked it out of the park. So thank you so much. Now, should we recognize the people in these groups, Lex?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So you got the list for In the Navy, right? From
I got Weird and Wonderful. Cool. It's Funny Honey, Emmy Honey, Emmy Smee, Telly 7706. Ran JFS PNR, Ralph RGK, Mark Witt Zero, Petrazilli, Kylus, who we've met before, Mrs. Sunny, the Kluven, and that's it. So great job, guys. I hope I didn't look for your name too badly.
No, very cool. And I think we have a song coming up later in the show that is from one of the folks in that group. Is that right? Pretty sure. I think so.
You mean the Weird Wonderful group?
Yes.
Maybe.
Yes.
It could
just
be.
Just say yes. All right. And then.
Yes,
we do. And then, all right. So the folks that were involved in Global Family doing Jump, that was Nat Sings, Levine 85, Bear Cub 68, I Am Ka. Bo Gring Huis, and I'm going to butcher these names because I don't know you guys, so I apologize. CMNX Olivier, Nicolo Piccolo, Joe Hunter 2, Patrachez, TJ Davidson 1979, Noreen 2020, One Amir One, and Teasing Man. So quite a list of folks, and just think of all the people we just had in that last set alone. And it was just so cool. I love these group songs, especially when you guys pull them together.
I
so
know,
well.
Man. Like, yeah. This is what I was talking about. Like when I said the diversity of this week's Happy Hour. Not to mention the fact you guys all know that Lex and I like to pair similar songs, similar genres up. It was so easy this week. Like this thing came together, like you know, like the jigsaw puzzle. There wasn't any missing pieces. They all like fit perfectly. Yep. So. Great job. Just fantastic stuff, man.
And I'm just thinking now, we definitely have one song coming up from someone in one of the two groups, but now I'm not sure which of the two groups it was, so I might have misspoke earlier. But definitely somebody. I think that's what was going. Like, what's she talking about?
Scratching my head. Like, yeah, sorry. It's all right, Lex.
That's what it was. Yeah. So you'll, yes, but there is someone coming up from one of the two groups.
All right, man.
Oh, yeah.
Speaking of what's coming up, you know, and I'm doing a shitty job of tagging in the line, you know, synergy chat, and I apologize. Rockin' Cherry.
Speaking of which, Tony, before you go forward, and in case you need a second to tag, if you're a new listener to the show, if you're just coming into us through either Twitch or through YouTube, couple of things to know. We do have a line chat room for Synergy Radio. We also simulcast to Synergy Radio. We have a lot of other great shows going on as part of Synergy Radio. So if you're not in the line chat room, it's called Chat Synergy. If you'd like to be in there, you can PM me or Tony, either post a note or a comment on after the show, or post it in chat, and we'll have somebody get you in there. I saw a couple of people who have been, looks like they were tuned in on YouTube and who were chatting with us on YouTube. It's interesting because the chats that you post will show up during the show. You'll see them coming up alongside the show, but I don't think the folks who are, if they're chatting on their phone in the Twitch chat, I don't think they'll see them there. So if you're looking to get involved with the chatting and the audience, you'll want to follow us on Twitch and come on over to the Twitch chat. If you need a link or something like that, post a note. Hopefully we'll see it or follow up with us after the show, and we'll make sure we get you in there.
Now, as Rockin' Cherry states, though, the Twitch, that's this chat on Twitch.
Yes.
Twitch, chat, Twitch. Since it's on Twitch, and you know, nobody wants to like chat in two different places, but you know, the Twitch is where it's at, man.
Yes.
The cool cats hang out in the Twitch. Yes. But I will tag people in the line synergy chat just to let them know that, hey, you're coming up. Although sometimes I get a little behind or just don't do it for like, I don't know, 4 or 5 sets in a row. But hey, Rockin' Cherry, speaking of which, you are up next. Our next set, we're combining Jane's Addiction and Civil Wars.
Oh, yeah.
Great set, man. Rockin' Cherry's going to bust out Had a Dad from Jane's Addiction. After that, Shanna Bunny Foo and the seldom seen blues harp.
Speaking of fabulous Synergy DJs.
Oh, yeah. Blues Harp, of course, a co-host of with Alfie. Of the long-running Rock Pile on Saturday nights here on Synergy Radio, but yeah, it's great to hear Blues Harp and Shanna. But
one of my favorite songs ever done with them too. It's a great song.
Yeah, they will be after Rockin' Cherry kicks us off with Had a Dad. A little Jane's Addiction coming up next on the Happy Hour with Lex and Tony.
Okay. Hey guys, welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. I'm sorry, we're all working on the side here. Tony's working on his tags. I'm working on some some chats to get.
I'm not on my phone.
No, you're not.
I give out my full attention, Lex.
All righty then. All right, so we kicked it off with a kick-ass song from Rockin' Cherry, "Had a Dad." Who did you say was the original artist on that one, Tony?
Jane's Addiction.
Yeah, very cool tune. Very cool. And Rockin' Cherry always brings like just so much of himself and so much attitude and so much just everything. He's just so much fun to watch. And then Blues Harp and Shanna doing this very cool Civil Wars tune called Barton Hollow. And Tim had introduced me to this tune. Gosh, I know, years ago, probably like one of the first songs he introduced me to, and I've always loved it. It's such a great song, and the two of them sounded fantastic together.
You know, so, how about the bass or the baritone, whatever you call it, a blues harp,
yes,
combined with the highs of Shanna? Oh my, that was great.
Isn't that cool?
Great, yes, blend.
Very cool. Yep. Nicely done, guys. Fabulous set right there.
You know, it's funny. I ask the question every time. I think I know Shanna Bunny Foo is Shanna in line. You know, because when people have different line names and mule names, it confuses me because I'm just a caveman. I don't know about your different names.
It's tricky.
I'm just Tony Wilk everywhere.
Tricky, can it, Tony?
It's tricky to rock a rhyme, to rock a rhyme. That's right, on time, it's tricky. What is it, Lex?
It's tricky. Yeah.
Now, the reason I do that, like at work, if somebody, you know, says something's tricky, I will immediately bust into that Run DMC and my coworkers kind of look at me.
Listen, if you're not going
to have... A lot of them are too young to know the song. They're like, what the hell are you saying?
If you're not going to give me a chance to do the rock set joke, I got to do something. You know, so I see it's one or the other. I got to have some kind of regular thing.
I mean, I've been like routine. I've been like department head meetings where I busted out on that and like, strike that from the minutes, please.
I could totally picture that being in the minutes. And then Mr. Wolf said,
"That was great stuff." And you know what? What we got coming up next, Lex? I got
yes.
Where are those glasses?
Oh boy!
Confound it!
This.
I can't see anything without my spectacles. Oh, here we go.
Don't make a spectacle of yourself there, Tony.
I know. I'll try not to make a spectacle of myself. Oh. Brindle Wolf. Now, when Brindle Wolf puts his mind to something, anything, and he usually does, every song he sings, I mean, it's going to come out kick-ass. Brindle Wolf actually sent us a little clubby, dancey song.
Yes.
We're going to have another dance set. Brindle Wolf is going to lead it off. And MTG Des will follow Brindle Wolf. Jellyhead is his song. MTG Des can do some Spice Girls.
Nice.
So what's MTG Des's Spice name? I'm trying to think.
You want to think about the music's playing? We'll come back to you with that in just a second. How does that sound?
maybe I should have known this before I mentioned it.
I think you had an idea last night, and I think you forgot what it was.
I think you're right. But honorary Spice Girl MTG Des will follow Brindle Wolf next up in our little week. We got a club set.
I'll remind you on the break.
Okay, yeah. Oh, there you go. Maybe maybe it wasn't for public knowledge and Lex's glad it didn't sing.
Oh, we'll talk. Here we go, guys.
You know what I gotta do? Before I gotta get to the bar. Hey, there we go. Welcome,
I was
Lex.
Lonely here. Look like there's no one here. It's terrible.
I know, but now there's two patrons, so that'll work. Just in time to hear some Brindle Wolf Jellyhead. Here we go. Happy hour, Lex and Tony.
So, you want to know what my favorite dance song is? Here it is. So what if your jeans are torn? They've been torn since bros were cool.
Over and over, I feel it, boyfriend. going to say this again. Let's go.
Hope you like it, okay? Just get-
Good thing Tony's not on his phone. Hey, guys.
I'm like tagging and chatting and trying to be a social butterfly. You're trying to keep up with that. Trying to keep up with the tags and the chats.
Are you?
Like, what I really keep up with is like the drinking. My wife came down here like brandishing a bottle of Svedka vodka. Now, I usually drink platinum because platinum is like the cheapest vodka that still tastes good. And she was like just like showcasing this. I'm like, well, thanks for the bottle service. But evidently it was on sale and she was trying to ask me, will you drink this? I'm like, well, does it, you know, is today a day that ends in Y? Yes, I will drink it. I was a bit off during our last break, but you know what? Not off are these tunes.
I'm telling
Holy
you, right?
Rats, listen, my friend,
Brindlewolf has been sending us some just amazing, beautiful, emotional ballads, things that like just rip your heart out. Tonight, he came back to us with like a very cool dancey club song. He had all the dance moves out. He had all the harmonies going. He just looked and sounded fabulous. He was having a great time. Yeah.
Sweet. I love that.
Yeah, very nice. Very nice. I love that, Brindlewolf. That was fabulous. And then MTG Dez giving us some Spice Girls. Now, Tony. Do you remember the
name?
I
remembered her Spice name. It was Penitentiary it? Spice.
Why Penitentiary
and,
Spice?
And the reason it's Penitentiary Spice, and I kind of had this like running joke with MTG Dez. She will post her food. You know, like you know, thank you for these blessings and this food. But it's in like this metal like tray that, you know, with compartments that looks like they would have in a prison. So it's kind of been a running joke. So the Penitentiary Spice and you know, the food that she posts though, she's like,
oh,
she's got like
so
many courses going
yes.
on.
I mean, oh my goodness.
It's not just like, you know, something she put in the microwave. There's like, you know, 6-7 different things going on.
It looks so good. It reminds me of like the like if you go to a Japanese restaurant, the bento boxes with all
of big
the
time.
Stuff.
Yeah. It's just, maybe it's something just like that. In a prison tray that I'm sure MTG Dez uses to, you know, to beat down the other prisoners over the head, you know, when there's a riot. Penitentiary Spice.
I think if you get the right kind of file, you can make that pretty pointy too. There's all kinds of uses for that metal plate. Oh my goodness. I don't know.
Yeah, that's the name I could not remember on our last break. But great job, MTG Dez, with the Spice Girls.
That was very cool. Very cool.
You joined up with Posh and Sporty and the other Spice, Scary, Dopey, Sleepy, and Doc.
We haven't heard from Doc in a while, actually, have we?
I know. The Forgotten Spice Girl. I don't know what's going on there. Yeah. But great set. We love that. We turned the happy hour bar into a dance club for the second time tonight. I told you things are diverse. And you know what? I'll tell you what's really diverse.
What's that?
We're going to take this thing back all the way to the 50s, early 60s.
I think that's going to be strange. You know,
with some doo-woppy type stuff. Yes, Love is Strange. Odie Juan Canote, who usually regales us with, like, you know, 70s and 80s, like, you know, rocker tunes. This is like, I recognize this song, but I think it's from the 50s.
Folks who have seen Dirty Dancing will recognize this song.
Oh, see, I've never actually seen Dirty
Dancing.
Are you
kidding me? Really?
You know what?
You gotta go to the library,
you can't
Netflix.
Put Tony in a corner.
Yeah,
I've
this
never
is
seen
true.
It.
You got to see it. Then.
So, Mickey and Sylvia.
It's an iconic movie.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna guess that Odie is Mickey and Simone Tellier must be Sylvia. Love is Strange, from originally released in 1956, but according to Lex, and I don't doubt Lex, it must have been in Dirty Dancing.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like I should lift Lex up like this, like vertically. For telling me that, because I had no idea.
It's good you know one scene of the movie. I think you know that scene from the old soundtracks promo From Jacqueline and Gary. I think it was in there.
That's right.
That's the only thing. The only thing Tony knows about Dirty Dancing is the promo from.
I guess I gotta watch it.
Show.
All I know is that I think
it's a fun movie.
Baby was is that her name? Jennifer Beals name? Wasn't she like underage and like the dance instructor Patrick Swayze? I mean, wasn't there like a kind of a, you know, 15 will get you 20 thing going on there? I could be wrong.
You gotta watch the movie.
Okay, well, I'm always on the lookout for, you know. Yeah. For these sex crimes in movies, because I'm a public watchdog.
You surely are. You're some kind of a dog, yeah. You are a dog, Tony. Let's go. What do we got?
Odie Wanconi and Simone Tellier. Love is Strange. Mickey and Sylvia from the movie Dirty Dancing. Coming up next on Happy Hour, Lex and Tony. And after that, Viva Las Vegas with Alan and Old Funky Pearl. Here we go.
Okay, you're Mickey, I'm Sylvia. When the music starts.
Love, love is strange. Take it for a game.
Yeah, yeah.
Once you get it, you'll never want to quit. No, no. After you've had it, yeah, yeah. You're in an awful fix. Many people don't understand. No, no. They think love. Your sweet loving is better than a kiss.
Yeah, yeah.
When you leave me, sweet kisses I miss. Simply say, baby, oh baby, my sweet baby, you're the one. Baby, oh baby,
yeah, yeah,
my sweet baby, you're the one.
Mickey. Thanks for singing with me. It ain't from Vegas.
What?
Up the bunkers.
Oh, jeez.
Bright light city, gonna set my soul. Gonna set my soul on fire. Got a whole lot of money that's ready to burn. So get those stakes up high.
There's a thousand party women waiting out there. They're all living the devil may care. And I'm just a devil with love to spare.
Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas.
How I wish that there were more than 24 hours in the day. Even if there were 40 more, I wouldn't sleep a minute away.
Oh, there's black
blackjack and poker and the roulette wheel. A fortune won and lost on every deal. All you need's a strong arm and a nerve of steel.
Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas.
Las Vegas with the neon flashing, corner bandits catching all those hopes down the drain.
Viva Las Vegas, turning day into nighttime, turning night and daytime. You see what? You'll never be the same again.
I'm gonna get it from my gun, I'm gonna have some fun. It cost me my very last dime. If I wind up broke up, I'll always remember that.
I'm gonna give you everything, everything I've got. Lady luck, please let the dice stay hard. Let me shoot a seven with every shot.
Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas with the neon flashing, corner bandits catching all those hopes down.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Hey guys, welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. And I tell you what, love is strange. And what's even more strange is that Tony has never seen the movie Dirty Dancing. You know, just because though, you've seen every movie in history,
I haven't seen the one everybody else has seen.
Well, that's a good one too.
I just have not seen Dirty Dancing. I always thought that's a chick flick. I'll pass. But regardless of that, I do believe Odie Juan Canote and Simone Tellier did a fantastic job on that.
They did.
I loved her hair with the blonde, like the thing going on there.
That is very cool. She's got a lot of stage presence and she kind of got into the role a little bit. That was great. I love having new folks on the show.
I'm Sylvia.
That's right. Yeah, she knew. She was like, wait, this is how we're going to do it. No, it sounded great. And Odie always finds great folks to sing with. And
usually known for like doing like April Wine songs. So you bust out with something from the 50s. That was great, man.
Very nice. Very nice. And
then, I don't mean to pigeonhole Odie does more than April Wine. I just view that. That's just his like.
Classic rock is definitely a strength for Odie, no question in my mind. So it's yes. And so then who do we have? We had Funky Pearl and Alan doing the Viva Las Vegas. And that was very cool too. You know, Alan likes to do the ballads and all the fancy songs with all the harmonies. He loves to do the harmonies, so it's fun when he goes out and does a little something different as well. So that was fantastic. No. And Funky Pearl, I don't think we've had her on the show before either. So we've had a lot of new contributors.
Alan, thank you for bringing her in.
Yes.
And Lex, I mentioned I've seen Viva Las Vegas. You would think it's all about, you know, the glitz and glamour of Vegas. It's an Elvis movie.
Yeah.
And I think he's like a race car driver. And I think his like rival is Bill Bixby.
Really? Well, that's interesting.
Like
Bill
courtship of Eddie's father.
Does anyone else know who you're talking about other than me and maybe Odie?
I think Bill Bixby is like the rival race car driver in that movie. I might be wrong, but. That's what I remember. So
it could be. That sounds very
I'll tell you who was just smoking hot in that movie, other than Elvis and Bill Bixby and Margaret.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Yeah.
I mean, man, there wasn't a hotter thing going on in the early to mid-60s than Anne Margaret, but I digress.
Focus.
I was going to say something, but I lost track. Oh, I know what it was.
I was going to hope you said you were going to say I thought better of it, but that never happens.
No, what I was going to say, I was talking about Odie and his penchant for like, you know, 70s, 80s, like classic rock. Odie, I'm going to throw out a challenge for you. Donnie Iris. Now, Donnie Iris is known for probably, you know, like a few songs. He was big around Pittsburgh, huge in Pittsburgh. The song I'm thinking of is Aaliyah, which is, Johnny Irish kind of looked like this. He had like glasses and kind of curly hair. My hair is not curly. Odie, I would love to hear you sing Johnny Irish's Aaliyah. There's some high parts in it, which Odie would be great at, and there's some normal parts in it, but Aaliyah is, believe me, you guys, you'll recognize the tune.
I think Odie recognizes it already. Is he in
there? You go. I'm not even going to, like, you know, attempt to, like, you know, give you a sample because I can't sing it. I've tried and failed miserably. I would love to hear Odie sing Aaliyah by Johnny Irish. Johnny Irish is, like I said, like, had a couple, you know, big hits in, like, the late 70s, 80s. But maybe Odie will take me up on the challenge.
So okay. before you tell us what's coming up next, I just wanted to mention, because you have the glasses on, and you just kind of reminded me. We're halfway. We're halfway through. Oh well, in theory, we're halfway through the show. I'm sure we're not. Next week on Happy Hour is going to be. The glasses. You reminded me a little bit of Seymour for a second there. Little Shop of Horrors, our first musical special for the year. Coming up next week, I know a lot of you guys who are listening tonight or we're playing tonight, you guys are, a lot of you guys are involved with the show. I know we've got about a week left to pull everything together. Some of the songs are just getting started to get closed. Some of them are just getting started. So I know it's going to be a fun week getting everything to closure. You guys have been fantastic. I love the way everybody's working together. Just wanted to remind you folks that next week's going to be that show. It'll be the same regular time or 7 o'clock start. But it'll be all the music from Little Shop of Horrors. So if you send us a song if you send us a song this week, it'll really be for the week after next. If you're not involved directly in the Little Shop of Horrors songs for next week, if you're not involved and you'd like to be involved, we are still pulling together the finale song. Lots of room for folks to just jump on the all parts, you know, the company parts. Definitely, you can do that. Just shoot me a PM, and we'll bring you in. And Rockin' Cherry, it's coming up next week, dude. You got to pull it together. We're gonna get there.
Rockin' Cherry, man.
He's getting nervous.
I cannot wait to see. I cannot wait to see your Audrey 2 plant. By the way.
Oh my gosh, yes. There are some things that the guys are trying out, like in these different songs, and it's so good, and it's so much fun, and it's gonna come together. Very nice.
I know, one of the more fun things, like we've done a few of these musicals on Happy Hour, and you know, it's quite the undertaking. I mean, I don't want to like minimize it. Right, people right now are furiously working on their songs. Like Lex set up like all kinds of like rooms for each song, and like, you know, we kind of check in to see what's going on, and like just great stuff is going to happen. Great stuff will happen next
week. It'll be fun.
Yeah. It'll be what we did: Grease, Rocky Horror, Guardians of the Galaxy. This will be our fourth Happy Hour musical production.
So it's only the second one on video, right? Or is it the third? Second.
Yeah, because the first video would have been Guardians.
That's right, because Grease and Rocky were both audio only. That's right.
And obviously, Little Shop presents, you know, some video like challenges, but people are dressing up and seriously. Whatever you guys come up with will be awesome. I've seen some like, you know, like girls playing Seymour. It's just adorable. Rockin' Cherry, I mentioned, he's got all kinds of like ideas, like to be Audrey to the plant. I can't wait. It's just going to be awesome. Next Friday, we will present Little Shop of Horrors. Like Lex and I will kind of narrate it and move along the story. But you know, you guys obviously are the stars that are putting this together and working on your song. So keep at it. Yep. We'll need them by next Thursday night.
Rockin' Cherry, trust me, it's going to be great. And we're not overselling it. It's just going to be a blast. It's going to be so much fun. Even if you guys, for some of the songs, they don't all have to dress up. People want to do different things. So don't get us wrong.
Seriously,
it's all going to be a mix. We've got everything from massive group songs to solo songs. Tremendously, like with our filibuster songs and these little tiny short songs with lots of people. It's all over the place and it's just fun. So no matter what, it's going to be
added
fun.
Bonus, there's a few songs that weren't in the movie that were in the stage
That's right.
musical that you might not you know, even be familiar with.
But they're fun. Like, oh, they're fun.
Some of the singers weren't familiar with them.
You're but like, what's that?
They are now. it'll be
good. It's good. It's good stuff. We've had songs that are like songs for like where one part split out into 20 parts, and songs where there's 20 parts all be done by one part. It's all over the place, and it's just going to be fun. So you're going to have to tune in. And again, like even if you were involved and you had to run out for something, you want to come back in. There's if you tell me soon, you can definitely jump into the company part, the alls for the finale, the Broadway finale will be fine. So if you want in, just shoot me a PM or text me after the show, and we will help you out. No worries. We want everyone who wants to be involved to get involved. It's fun. All right. I wanted to make sure people knew that it's going to be next week.
Next week will be a blast. Seriously. Yes. All these musicals are always so fun. And it's just so awesome to see everyone working together. Like, you don't see it like behind the scenes like we do, but like people are just like they are just going off in terms of just working together. And special thanks to our song runners, if you will, our coordinators who are putting it together, because that is a yeoman's task. We'll put it that way.
Yeah. No. Everyone, but everyone's been working together really nicely, which helps a lot. So, you guys are going to love the show. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, Tony.
All right, Lex. Now I'm going to shift gears to our next set. Remember, I very diverse this week.
Yes.
We have a set. These are both songs, I believe, from the 70s. And they both deal with love gone wrong, I guess. Yeah, relationships that, maybe could have been better. I don't know. We're going to start it off with Brenda. I am Brenda, stuck in the middle with you. Hello, Steeler's Wheel. Hello, Reservoir Dogs, a movie I have seen, Lex.
That's a hell of a movie. Yeah.
Brenda's going to do the Steeler's Wheel tune from that movie, followed up with Denise Perry Havoc, 50 Ways to Leave Your Lover, Paul Simon. Hello, this is going to be a great, and I mean great, set. So let's kick it off with Brenda. Stuck in the middle with you. On the happy hour, Lex and Tony.
Proud that you're a self-made man. And your friends, they all come crawling and slap you on the back and say, please. Don't know why I came here tonight. I got the feeling that something ain't right. I'm so scared in case I fall off my chair, and I'm wondering how I'll get down the stairs. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Here I am stuck in the middle with you.
Yes, I'm
stuck in the middle with you. Stuck in the middle with you. Here I am,
stuck in the middle with you. Thanks for joining.
Thank you.
Problems all inside your head, she said to me. The answer's easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle to be free. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. She said it's really not my habit to intrude. Furthermore, I hope my meeting won't be lost or misconstrued. But I'll repeat myself. At the risk of being crude, there must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Or just get yourself free. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key you leave and get yourself free. Ooh, slip out the back, Jack. Make a new play and stand. You don't need to be coy, Roy. You just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key and leave and get yourself free. She said it grieves me so to see you in such pain. I wish there was something I could do to make you smile again. And I said, I appreciate that. And would you please explain about the 50 ways? She said, why don't we both just sleep on it tonight? And I believe in the morning you'll begin to see the light. And then she kissed me, and I realized she probably was right. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new play and stand. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Or just get yourself free. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just chop off the key you leave and get yourself free. Slip out the back, Jack. Make a new play and stand. You don't need to be coy, Roy. You just listen to me. Or hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, leave, and get yourself free.
Oh, it is nice to have Denise back on the show. Havoc with 50 Ways to Leave Your Lover. Very nicely done. She's got such a great sense of timing and feel and rhythm, and she's just fabulous. I love having her on the show. And of course, we kicked it off with Stuck in the Middle with You. That was Brenda, and now she had somebody singing with her. Did you have the other?
Be Magic. Yeah,
Be
I'm
Magic.
Sorry.
There you go.
I didn't front sell Be Magic.
Yep.
Brenda sent that in, and Be Magic was the partner on that. And like iconic song that, quite frankly, got new life when Reservoir Dogs came out.
And not a lot of things got new life in that, I must say. So, hell of a movie. Yeah. If you're not into not everyone loves that movie. It was a very good movie, though.
Quentin Tarantino at his
finest. I know a lot of movies, just not the movies you usually bring up.
See, that's one both myself and Lex have watched. So there you go. We have that in common. So thank you for sending that in, Brenda. Very appreciative.
Very
and
cool.
Denise, it's fabulous to have you back on the show. In fact, I commented, it's funny, I in the Twitch that Denise sounded very sultry. It auto-corrected to like something else. I'm like, no.
What did you say?
It auto-corrected to slutty. I'm like, no.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Are you typing that a lot to people?
I guess.
Tony,
or maybe auto-correct knows what's in my head.
That's even scarier. Yeah. That's not a good thing.
But I made sure to go back and like make sultry, very sultry Denise Perry Abbott.
There you go.
All
yeah,
right,
she's
man.
Fantastic. All righty.
Okay, coming up, man. This is a fun little set we got coming up. First of all, April Bizou and Adam TX, also known as Ali AF. You know Ali. With the unicorns and stuff in his name.
Uh-huh.
I'm not sure who was responsible for the video style, but it is so cool. There's like an animated like cartoon thing going on here. Be Around Me is the name of the song. I love
it. Yes.
This video. This is, quite frankly, this is like the pleasure of doing a video show so you guys can see stuff like this.
Yeah.
Now don't get me wrong. We love to see your faces but just like when people actually put I don't know what they did, quite frankly. I'd love to know.
It's a very unique. This is unique. You haven't seen anything quite like this the way they did it. It's very cool. You're going to love it.
And following that, Frank Michael and IB Patty, we got to get the musicals in here. They will do a selection from Les Mis, A Little Fall of Rain. So this is, nice. We could sort of kind of call this our musical set.
It's an artistic set, I could say.
Artistic,
for sure.
There you go. It's just like we're patrons of the arts on the happy hour on this set. So there we go, patrons of the arts. And you can make your donations to happyhour.com.
No, you can't. We don't do donations.
There's no donations.
Don't confuse anybody, because otherwise we'll start getting all kinds of issues. There's nothing. We do this just for fun and the love of music. No, don't confuse anybody.
All right, guys. Maybe we can make a little side hustle out of that.
Yeah.
No, we won't. If you do,
it won't be with me.
That's a fleeting idea that came and went.
Yeah.
All right, let's kick off our artistic set, and I'll try to look artistic with my glasses on my nose. Let's kick it off with April Bizou and Ali AF with Be Around Me, a fine animated video.
Again, are we destined to be friends? I wanna give you more than that.
You are smoky 10-10, and I got some time.
matter much, it felt alright. Can't get you out of my mind. I'm around, be around, come around, be around me.
Take my heart and assess the damages. Want you crawling up me, baby, don't stop now.
Days before you, a pale in comparison, I must adore you.
And honestly, I heard November hates you. And all the cloudy shit, gray skies, you break through. But everybody knows you in June. Did you call me baby?
Maybe.
Oh.
Is that okay?
Yeah, it's cool. I liked it.
Cool.
Be around me.
I'm around, around, around.
Ooh. I can't
your memories, I don't feel any pain. A little fall of rain can hardly hurt me now. You're here, that's all I need to know. And you will keep me safe, and you will keep me close, and rain will flowers grow.
But you will live for me, dear God above. If I could heal your wounds with words of love,
just hold me now and let it be. Shelter me, comfort me.
You would live 100 years if I could show you how. I won't desert you now.
The rain can't hurt me now. This rain will wash away what's past. And you will keep me safe, and you will keep me close. I'll sleep in your embrace at last. The rain that brings you here is heaven bless. The skies begin to clear and I'm at rest. A breath away from where you are, I've come home from so far. So don't you fret, Monsieur Marius, I don't feel any pain. A little fall of rain can hardly hurt me now.
I'm here.
That's all I need to know. And you will keep me safe.
Hey guys, and welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. You could tell I'm doing all these very original welcome back statements tonight, aren't I? Say the same thing every time. April Bizu and Adam TX, aka Ali, doing Be Around Me with the very cool, like I told you, we had a cool tune, T-O-O-N, on the show. That is the cool tune I was referring to. I just love the video style. The song is so much fun. However they pulled that together, it came out fantastic. So absolutely.
You don't remind me of, I'm going to like harken back to the old MTV days, the video for Sledgehammer.
Yes, absolutely. Gabriel. Yeah, I totally see that. Yeah. Yes, very cool.
Great job on that.
Yeah. You know what's funny? We had seen, you and I both had seen that video posted somewhere, one of the rooms, I forget which room. It wasn't our room because we don't have a room. And you and I both saw it somewhere. And we both said, we got to play that on the show. Well, for the last, I don't know, 2 or 3 weeks, we've been saying, well, we're going to play it. But then April would send us a song, or April was going to be away. So this week she actually sent it. So we didn't have to go. I had on my notes, ask April, can we play this song? Because we loved it so much. So that was kind of a cool coincidence. The timing worked out fantastic. Yeah, April and Adam are both great with the video styles and stuff. And then Frank Michael and I.B. Patty, just an absolutely beautiful, beautiful song, Little Fall of Rain from Les Mis. I tell you, I look at them both in that video, and I said to Tony, while the music was playing, I said, Tony, can you not just picture their faces like on a playbill, on a Broadway playbill? Oh, they just time. Have that, like, that je ne sais quoi. I mean, there's like that look, and I could just picture them on a playbill. I thought it's so cool. Fabulous singing, like, absolutely spot on.
Je ne sais quoi. De la Max, if that's French.
To the max. I guess it could be. I don't know what to the max, if that makes sense. I get the point. I get the gist.
Seriously, that was like beautiful. Now, yeah, it's funny. Gorgeous. I'm very familiar with Les Mis or Les Miserables. A little story. I used to coach like baseball teams. In fact, I probably have a good 10 seasons coaching baseball teams with my kids. We're on the teams, obviously. And it's funny, one year, like, we had a really great team assembled, and our star player, like, maybe, I don't know, 3/4 of the way through the season was like, you know what, coach? I play like the singing street urchin in Les Miserables, so I'm gonna be missing the rest of the season. I'm like,
what? So this is what you know about Les Mis, huh?
So I went and saw him, you know, support the kid. But I'm like, yeah, thanks, buddy, for seriously, we missed him in the lineup. Oh. He was like the star. And now it's like, okay, street urchin, you know, you could have, why don't you sing whatever, you know, at first base. But anyway, I went and saw I went and saw the Les Mis show, and he did a great job. But like, man, we missed him. We missed him on the diamond.
You know, I tell you, kids got to make tough choices. I mean, if you can't do it, you can't do it all. And kids try to do it all, but you can't always do it all.
There you go. He made his tough choice.
Tough choices, yeah.
And cost me the pennant.
Oh, damn.
It's fine. I'm not bitter.
You're not bitter, right? Not at all. Yeah.
We are our next set. You know what we have? There's like, it's a little bit acoustic, a little bit of new Smuler. Whoop, whoop.
Oh, yes, this is cool.
Now, we moved some things around here. I'm familiar with the first song. You know, I wear my sunglasses at night. Is that Corey Hart, I think? Oh, not the Corey Hart that played for the Milwaukee Brewers.
Oh, definitely not. I don't think that. No, I'm not sure.
You don't think? Am I off? It's not Corey Hart?
No, it's not that Corey Hart, for sure. It's funny. It could turn out that it is that Corey Hart, and I would have no idea.
There was a guy on the Milwaukee Brewers, Corey Hart, and when he would come to bat, you know, like the walk-up music. That was like a big joke in Major League Baseball. So funny. Boca and is it Gigi, a.k.a. Gigi? Ingenue Gigi. It's an acoustic version of Sunglasses at Night, Hart song. We'll kick off this set. Second song is a Pink original, or originally done by Pink song, I Don't Believe You, by brand new, not just a brand new submitter, a brand new Smuler.
Oh, no, that's the name of the song. Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. The brand new Mueller, is it Tiff Davidson?
Tiff Davidson.
Is she in the Twitch?
Yes, I believe that is Ape's Mama. Is she Twitch name.
Blowing my mind with the different names? Ape's Mama?
I think so. I'll double check while we play
Tiff
Davidson the songs.
Yeah. Are one and the same. If not, I'm sorry, but I think they are. So that's our next set coming up. So it's nighttime. I need my sunglasses. I don't have them, but that's okay. Boca and Gigi will take care of that with the acoustic version of the Corey Hart classic. Yeah, coming up next on the Happy Hour with Lex and Tony.
Sunglasses at night, so I can watch you weave a pretty story's end. Because my security, she's got control of me. I turn to her and say, don't put your head on the dying chair tomorrow. Do masquerade with the guy you share. I can't believe that, cause you got
I don't mind it all. You're the swing set, and I'm the kid that falls. It's like the way we fight, the times I've cried, we come too close, and every night the passion's there, so it's gotta be right. Right. No, I don't believe you when you say don't come around here no more. I won't remind you, you said we wouldn't be apart. No,
guys, welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. What a fabulous set. We had some long beloved regulars and some brand new talent right there. Kicking it off, we had Boca and Gigi doing Sunglasses at Night. Very cool acoustic version. And I will say, I think they sang it in the daytime and I clearly had no sunglasses, but it still worked.
You know, that maybe it wasn't the nighttime. It wasn't the right time.
Oh, it was the right time. But I don't know. You know, I know what you mean. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just giving them a hard time. That was cool. I love that version. Boca, you always find such great folks to sing with. I don't know whether they join you. You join
them. Ingenues.
I know. I do know that Boca Boca's loves. Ingenues. He loves to go and join folks.
Boca if, and if MTV you have something open, have ingenues
he'll find
and
you,
non-genues.
And he will join you. Yeah, he's great. He's fabulous with singing with folks. And then Tiff Davidson, welcome to the show. I Don't Believe You by Pink. What an absolutely beautiful version of that. Very excited to have you on there. And it's just absolutely fantastic.
You know, I Googled Corey Hart, you know, Sunglasses at Night original singer.
Yep.
And like the first like 10 or 12 responses on Google were from, you know, Corey Hart, the singer. It took until about the 11th or 12th thing to bring up Corey Hart, the baseball player from
really?
The Brewers.
Poor now, guy.
Corey Hart from the Brewers was a two-time All-Star, and he hit 162 lifetime home runs. I think he deserves more cred in a Google search, but yeah, that's just me, man.
Well, yeah. You know, I think a lot of it has to do with what people are actually looking for.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe
so they play him anyway. Yeah.
Maybe people aren't searching for Corey Hart, the baseball player. One thing Lex doesn't know about me, but I'm gonna fill her in. My music knowledge is quite surpassed by my baseball fandom.
Oh,
knowledge.
I think I knew that.
You did.
I think I did. I think I've told you a bunch of times. I said you should be like you should have been a sports announcer because you have all
actually,
of the.
Actually, I kind of slacked off maybe like 10 years ago, but believe me, from about 1977 ish. Through about, you know, the year 2000, yeah, I'm like a baseball encyclopedia, quite frankly. But yeah. But that's neither here nor there.
I'll tell you the other thing is, darn it, I'm gonna forget, because we were talking about, oh, I know what it was, because a lot of times when we're prepping the show on a Thursday night, Tony's like, he's half prepping the show and half like watching a game, whatever it is, depends on the time of year. But I can hear him. He'll give me like the play-by-play of the games, you know, if he's watching, so I don't think he forgot
I'll be
about
like,
me.
Hang on, Caitlin Clark from three.
So he's got all the skills to do this whole sport. That's why I'm not surprised at all. But yeah. And your knowledge on like everything is crazy good. So
well, thank you, Lex.
Very impressive. It's like co-hosting with David Miller and I'm sorry, Dennis Miller. it's been a long night. Because it's like you're it's like your co-host knows everything. You sit here going, who sang that? It's all right. I run the boards. You guys gotta just deal with that.
You know what? And seriously, I couldn't do this without Lex. I seriously could.
You could.
Not do
you wouldn't
this
like
without
it.
Lex.
You could.
I got no technical skills. Like,
you do. You just have no patience. But you totally could run the show yourself. Yeah. Just saying.
Yeah, no patience.
I could not cover what you cover myself. Well, I mean, I could, but I don't want to. It'd take too much studying.
I tell you what I got patience for.
What's
and that's
that?
Good tunes.
Oh, yes.
Because you know what's coming up? Our next set? Now we have, I think we're pacing a little behind, if I'm not mistaken.
Shocking.
Go figure. We have.
I don't know why nobody wants to follow us as a show lately. I can't understand it.
we have five sets left. So seriously, if you're tuned in, stay tuned in. You know, like, text your friends, call your neighbors, get them on the show. There's still plenty of show left. Five awesome sets of music still here. And the next one, it's a rock set, right? Oh, shit.
Is it a rock set?
Yeah.
I gotta love rock set.
But there'll be no rock set sung. These will be classic rock songs. Well, you know, I'm not sure the first one is a classic rock song because it's Jonathan Leighton rocks.
No,
and once again,
I'm gonna say this is
not.
Oh, it's Breaking
Benjamin. It's Breaking Benjamin.
I'm sorry.
Not a classic
rock set at all.
Okay.
Just to say,
okay.
This is more of like a new metal set.
It's a metal set, not
go.
Classic rock.
No.
Like, I'm showing my age. I think Metallica
is
classic
rock.
I think Breaking Benjamin is classic rock.
Yeah.
It really is.
No. But look at Rockin' Cherry, because if this is classic rock, I give up.
Yeah, Rockin' Cherry, I'm sorry. I misspoke. You know,
it's
late.
It's been a long night for both of us.
I've had a few vodkas. my wife bottle service be some Svedka. Svedka vodka kicks ass, man. I may switch platinum. Over. It comes in this like big glass bottle. I'm afraid, like, you know, I tend to like drop things. I'm clumsy, so I'm scared of that glass bottle. But anyway, Jonathan Leidenrocks is going to blow you away with "Blow Me Away," Breaking Benjamin, yes, one of Lex's favorite bands.
Absolutely.
Following that would be Ketlow. Mandatory Metallic Ketlow, Metallica's "Sad But True."
Sounds great.
We're going to kick some MFN ass right now, getting into the metal shop, on Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. Take it away, Jonathan Leidenrocks. Metal shop.
I'm waiting for you. Sorry. Just waiting for you to like take a breath. Here we go.
There used to be a show called The Metal Shop. I think it was on my local radio station. Metal Shop.
I love it.
I was at Metal Shop in high school. I got a fucking C. That's fucking different. Dick. It's like welding and stuff. I got a C. Like, what the fuck, dude? But anyway, it cost me the valedictorianship because I got a goddamn C in welding and Metal Shop.
Wow. That's a lot of info just there.
I'm not bitter. Take it away, Jonathan Leidenrocks, and I hope you can weld better than me and get better than a C in Metal Shop.
I'm trying, Rock and Cherry. I'm trying. Here we go, guys.
Hey, I'm your life. I'm the one who takes you there. Hey, hey, I'm your life. I'm the one who cares. They'll betray. I'm your only true friend now. They'll betray. I'm forever there. I'm your dream, make it real. I'm your eyes when you must hear. I'm your pain when you can't feel. Sad but true. I'm your dream, mind astray. I'm your eyes while you're away. I'm your pain while you repay. You know it's sad but true. Sad but true. You're my mask, you're my cover, my shelter. You, you're my mask, you're the one who's blamed. Do my work, do my dirty work, scapegoat. Do my deeds, you're the one who shames. I'm your dream, make you real. I'm your eyes when you must feel. I'm your pain when you can't feel. Sad but true, I'm your dream, mind astray. I'm your eyes while you're away. I'm your pain while you repay. You know it's sad but true. Sad but true.
That was a cool set. Oh, I loved it. All right, so Jonathan Layden rocks, kicking off the set with one of my absolute favorite bands, Breaking Benjamin. Blow me away, and it surely did. Love it when he breaks out the Breaking Benjamin. Yes. Oh, and then Ketlow with the mandatory Metallica Ketlow Sad but true. Love the video. I think I'm still trying to figure out how everybody gets these videos with all the dark, like just a black background. There's probably some simple way to do it, but I'm always sitting against my, you know, my wall that's gray or blue or depending on where I am.
And my wall is beige and it matches my skin.
It's not good.
And it blends together. It's like I hate it. I mean, do I need to wear like a black sheet? Like
I don't know.
Not wear, but put a black sheet behind me.
You know who's got some very cool backgrounds? If you haven't checked out any of her songs lately, is Pagan Lady. I think she's got some very, like, these really cool, like all these different, very interesting, I don't know whether it's like a photography background or fancy, like, sheets or whatever it is, but they are very cool. Go and check her her channel out on Smule, and you'll see what I'm talking about. We need to get some of those on here soon. Wow, Jonathan Layden rocks, and Kello, you totally rocked my world with that set. That was fantastic.
The rocker, like again, the diversity in tonight's happy hour is
yeah, we got something for everyone air. Tonight. Absolutely.
Exactly. So thank you, Jonathan Layden rocks, for the Breaking Benjamin, or BB as we call them, and Kello with the mandatory Metella. Kello had like the Canucks hat on, then he doffed it. great video. Now I've got my Iowa hat on because
see that.
By golly, the Hawks are taking on UConn. Let's go, Lady Hawks! But you know, I'm still gonna do the show.
We'll just need the play-by-play if you start getting distracted.
Looking over my shoulder, you know, because Lady Hawkeyes, Caitlin Clark, Final Four game against UConn coming on soon. But stay tuned to Happy Hour because you know it.
Uh-oh. All right, so Tony is stuck for a second. I don't know. Can you still hear me, Tony? Maybe the gremlins are getting to him. All right, so in case he is truly stuck, I'm going to go ahead and... Oh, here you are. You there, Tony?
I'm back!
All right, there
you go.
You know
what? Like, all the people... All the people in Iowa streaming the Iowa game
have
sucked up the bandwidth, and I don't have any internet connection.
That could be. That literally could be the case.
I think that's the case. Anyway.
You're definitely slow. So go ahead and do the friend cell. Let's get to the music.
We have a Miley Cyrus set coming up. No, that's just me being slow.
Okay, no, but you're still in slow motion, so it's very interesting.
Laura Iommi and Priceless, as opposed to Princess Anna, Priceless Anna,
yes,
93, are going to two Miley Cyrus songs. They're not, I don't think they're Hannah Montana songs, because that would be like the...
Oh, definitely, not the first one, absolutely not. The second one, I don't know, so...
You know, and I haven't previewed the video, but... Do Laura Iommi and Priceless Anna dress up in that like safety pin dress that Miley Cyrus wore at the Grammys?
They certainly did not dress up like her video of Wrecking Ball. I could tell you that.
I can only hope that too. But you know what? No matter how they dressed up, these songs will kick ass.
Yes.
Here comes Laura Iommi, used to be young, Miley Cyrus, followed by Flowers, Priceless Anna, Miley Cyrus, our Miley Cyrus set. Coming up next on the Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. Let's go, Hawks!
I promise they won't be slow-mo like Tony. Here we go, guys. Laura Iommi kicking us off first. Used to be young.
Truth is bulletproof, there's no fooling you. I don't dress the same. Me and who you say I was yesterday have gone our separate ways. Left my living fast somewhere in the past, cause that's for chasing cars. Turns out open bars lead to broken hearts and going way too far. To be young, you tell me time has sure changed me. That's fine, I had a good run. I know I used to be crazy, that's cause I used to be young. Take one, pour it out, not worth crying about the things you can't erase. Like tattoos and regrets, words I never meant and ones that got away. Left my living fast somewhere in the past and took another road. Turns out crowded rooms empty out as soon as there's somewhere else to go. Oh, I know I used to be crazy. I know I used to be fun. You say I used to be wild. I say I used to be young. You tell me time has sure changed me. I used to be young. Oh, 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 oh. I know I used to be crazy, messed up, but God, was it fun? I know I used to be wild. That's 'cause I used to be young.
Those wasted nights are not wasted.
I remember everyone. I know I used to be crazy. That's 'cause I used to be young. You tell me time has sure changed me. That's fine, I had a good run. I know I used to be crazy. That's 'cause I used to be young.
Help me rock this.
You got it.
Woo!
Finally found time to join on this one.
We were good, we were gold. Kind of dream that can't be sold. We were right till we were built a home and watched it burn.
I didn't want to leave you, I didn't want to lie. Started to cry but then remembered
I can buy myself flowers and the name in the sand. Talk to myself for hours, say things you don't understand.
I can take myself dancing, and I can hold my hand. Yeah, I can love me better than you can.
Can love me better, I can love me better, baby. Can love me better, I can love me better than my nails. Cherry red, mats of roses that you left.
No remorse, no regret. I forget every word you say.
Ooh, I didn't wanna leave, I didn't wanna fight. Started to cry, but then remembered
I can buy myself flowers.
That's right.
Write my name in the sand. Talk to myself for hours, say things you don't understand.
I can take myself dancing, yeah. I can hold my own hand. Yeah, I can love me better than you can. Can love me better, I can love me better, baby. Can love me better, I can love me better,
baby.
Can love me better, I can love me better, baby. Can love me better. Ooh, I didn't wanna leave you,
I didn't wanna fight. Sorry
to cry, but then remembered I can buy myself flowers.
Write my name in the sand.
Talk to myself for hours.
Say things you don't understand.
I can take myself dancing, and I can hold my own hand. Yeah, I can love me better than, yeah.
welcome.
Hey guys, welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony, who is very, very busy, probably tagging somebody somewhere.
Yeah, I had to like in the line chat, I had to tag people, but I'm sorry, I'm here now.
Good, good, good. And you're back. Like, you're not in slow motion anymore. We can hear you and see you in real time.
Which that's good.
Way better than hearing you in real time and seeing you in slow motion. I don't know if everybody was seeing the same thing going out, but I imagine they were. It's just a little tricky. Okay, so Used to Be Young, Laura Iommi kicking it off with this very emotional, very cool song from Miley Cyrus. Definitely not one of her older songs, definitely one of her newer songs. You know, Laura always brings so much emotion to her songs, and just what a fabulous tune right there.
You know what's funny? When I think of Miley Cyrus, I think of two things. I think of Hannah Montana, and I think of like Wrecking Ball and Party in the USA. Both of these songs, I'm like, wow, that's Miley Cyrus. I mean, I'm not a big Miley Cyrus fan, but like, both of these are like, seriously, both of you guys like just kicked ass on these. I mean, I have a new appreciation for Miley Cyrus. She's not just a safety pin dress wearing Robin Thicke dry humping whatever. And there you go. I'm just throwing it out there, like.
interesting perspective as usual from Tony. And then Priceless Anna and Melissa doing Flowers. Now, we had them, I think we had the two of them together, was it last week or the week before, with I can't remember the name of the tune now, it totally escapes me, but it was like a dance tune. I had it in my head, like, and then now it's gone. But they sounded just great on Flowers. Very cool song. A lot of meaning behind that song as well. And so great that, to have,
that's what I'm
have
saying.
The two of them
like,
together
Miley
on the
Cyrus
show.
Miley Cyrus has got some like meaningful songs, despite the, you know, I'm like naked all the time, or you know, like high on sativa. I mean, like Miley Cyrus she's a respectable artist.
Yes,
are Laura Iommi and Priceless Anna. They're respectable
artists. She's had a very interesting career for sure, you know, and all the history and, you know, her background and her dad and all that stuff. So you got to give her some props.
Who's
her
dad?
All that
what do you mean?
Shush.
Oh, Billy Ray Cyrus. and he was like her dad on the Hannah Montana show.
Yeah, that's, yes. So, you know, she had to go through some things. You know, that's complicated. But yeah, she is very talented, and she's done all kinds of things. And as are all the folks on our show tonight. You guys have been, these videos are incredible. In fact,
I'm telling you, the diversity on tonight's show is like as diverse as Happy Hour has ever been. We're like the freaking Rainbow Coalition on Happy Hour tonight. Like, we are running the gamut of every possible music genre. And you know what? We got another one coming up. Another genre coming up, Lex.
What's that?
You ready?
You
ready for the front cell?
Ready.
Okay. Yeah. We're going to like delve back until like the singer, songwriter, like balladeer, Bob Dylan. Actually, it's like, you know what? It's kind of a Bob Dylan set.
Yes.
We're going to kick it off with Cackham, Carol. Rackham, Stackham, Pascal Siakam, Cackham is going to sing The Times They Are a-Changin', Bob Dylan song. But she does like the Brian Ferry arrangement.
This is such a cool version of this. Yes.
Oh, it is. Seriously. Yes. After that, we have Papa Dave. Papa Dave. Duquesne Whistle.
Nice.
Bob Dylan song. So we got a little Bob Dylan superset coming up. I told you it was diverse tonight. These two songs are great. So stay tuned, relax, chill out, smoke a spliff, whatever you gotta do. We got Cackham, Papa Dave coming up on Happy Hour with Lex and Tony.
Mm-hmm.
gather round people wherever you go, and admit that the waters around you have grown. Accept it soon, you'll be drenched to the bone. If your time to you is worth saving, then you better start swimming. You could sink like a stone, for the tides, they are a-changing. Come mothers and fathers throughout the land, and don't criticize if you can't understand. Your sons and your daughters beyond your command. Your old road is rapidly aging, so get out of the new one if you can't lend a hand. The times, they are a-changing. Curse that is cast. The slow one now will later be fast. The present now will later be past. The order is rapidly fading, and the first one now will later be last. For the times, they are a-changing. For the time. For the time. Changing.
Oh, Papa Dave with the Duquesne whistle. Very cool. I tell you, Tony, and I've told you this many times in the past, if you go back to when we used to do like the individual artist-focused specials that we did, Papa Dave was probably one of the nicest folks that I interviewed for those specials.
Oh, that's right. Like Lex used to do Spotlight with Alexis. I remember those.
Yeah, I really enjoyed doing those because it was just so focused on...
Where was the Spotlight Tony Wilkes?
You know, I offered you that many times and you said no. Nope, Tony just turned me down.
No,
he's like,
no.
Who wants to know? I said, they would love that.
I'm not spotlightable. You know what?
If we ever bring the show back, you're going to be the first spotlight. It'll be great.
Could
you imagine the things that Tony would share on a spotlight special about Tony? I can't even. It would just be too much fun.
But no. There'll be no spotlight Tony Wilkes, but I do remember the spotlights that Alexis used to do, and I do remember the Papa Dave one. And yeah, you're right, he was the nicest dude like ever.
Yeah, but I mean, like you got, yeah. I mean, even like behind. So everyone, I honestly and I truly mean this, and I say honestly, but I'm always very honest. Everyone that I interviewed for that show was wonderful and talented and beautiful people in their own right. But there was something about Dave. He's just so down to earth and friendly and humble and just, I always come back to that. He was like just the nicest guy, and he is the nicest guy. So I always think of that whenever we play his songs. Everyone loves his voice and they know his tunes and all his originals. But what always, you know, tugs my heart is the chance I had to sit and talk with him from like an hour as we were putting together the show, and it was just so much fun to hang out with Dave and Libby. So good folks
there.
You're
right, and like Papa Dave, and this is gonna sound so like contrite. Papa Dave is just the dude.
Yeah,
he's just mellow.
Yeah,
like he's just genuine.
Yes,
he's just the dude. Like that's exactly right. I know that's the best thing I can say about Dave.
I know what
he's
you mean.
He's just the dude.
he's a good guy.
Thank you, Papa Dave. We appreciate, like, love that song, by the way. That was so cool.
Very cool.
We had a little Bob Dylan set going on. Nice. With Carol, the times are changing.
Adam, when I saw the song come in, and I'm thinking, oh, I know that song. I never heard it done like that. It was just, I really loved the way that was done.
That's great, Cackham. Rackham, Stackham, Haskell, Siakam, Cackham.
do you want to explain yourself?
Do people know who Pascal Siakam is? I hope. He played for the Raptors. I don't know if he plays for now. Maybe he's still with the But I'm just rhyming,
I just picture Carol going, what the hell is he talking about? Whenever he brings me up, he says this weird thing. I don't know what he's saying.
I'm just rhyming Rackham, Stackham, Pascal, Siakam, and Cat.
And it's probably mostly for him to remember how to pronounce it, because I know there was issues the first time. This is why I stick with Carol. I just stick with Carol, and I'm very happy with that, because Carol is a lovely name. All right, so what do we got coming up? We got a very cool set coming up next.
All right, Meg, come up. Nipper, thanks for coming back. Nipper had to like wash the dishes or do the laundry or some task. And then she said, well, I'll be away. Please tag me. Well, I tag you, Nipper. Like, you know what? my tagging skills are a little...
By the end of the night, they get very wonky.
That's the official term at the beginning of the night. I don't know why. I just can't like get with the program to tag people. But I tagged the Nipper.
I've offered to do the tagging on occasion, and he says no. So I can't help with that.
I view it as my job, but I just don't do my job.
Do you though? You got one job.
Don't do it. You got one job, to tag people.
Actually, it's not that.
And not get drunk during happy hour.
Well you're not good at any of them.
I fail at both. Why am I so fucking red? Look at me right. Look at my face. It doesn't look red to you?
Yeah. Did I say something embarrassing?
Like, okay, hang on. I'm going to...
Now you look black and white. I don't know what happened there. It's fine. What do we got coming up?
I was a growly, red-ass motherfucker.
Yeah. I look red and growly. I got to tone
that shit down.
Did you change what you have on your computer screen there?
Okay. I'm actually a little more mellow.
Better, yeah.
Ooh. Mellow. All right. Nipper. Nipper is coming up. Nipper. Followed by Sammy Gothic Lily Vampire Sammy Gothic Lily Dow.
None of that rhymes, that's, by the way. That's just a whole different story.
It's sort of a soft rock, pop rock set, because, you know, we always pair the shit together. Not that it's shit. No, it's good. Don't, I don't want to say shit.
We understand what you mean.
Nothing is shit.
There's difference between shit and the shit. And this is the shit.
The shizit, as Lex would say, because she likes to rap.
God.
Whoop.
Oh, dear. Don't get me started.
Lex is loving Ludacris these days. Why are you tucking that shit in my ear? Anyway, Crystal Catnip, show me love. Nipper, will you show us love?
Get back.
Following that, Sammy is going to be calling you. This is our penultimate set on the Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. Yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop.
Get back, Tony. We're going to play some music. Here we go.
And promises, I've had more than my share. I'm tired of giving my love and getting nowhere.
What I need is somebody who really cares. I can't put my love on the line that I hope you'll understand.
So baby, if you want me, you've got to show me love.
Words are so easy to say, oh yeah. You've got to show me love. Caught up in those one night affairs. I really need somebody who will always be there.
Don't you promise me the world, 'cause all that I've already
speak louder than words. If you're looking for devotion, talk to me, yeah.
Come with your heart in your hand,
because my love is guaranteed. So baby, if you want me, show me love.
Love that set right there. Crystal Catnip kicking us off with Show Me Love. Now, I have Crystal's name, and of course, I don't have her singing partner's name in front of me. Do you happen to have it handy, or could you pull that up for me?
Oh, hang on.
I'm sorry, Tony. I should have had that.
I'll be quick on the draw.
But yeah, it's a beautiful song. And like we were talking about, like folks who are on the show who have like these very unique and highly recognizable vocals. And of course, Crystal Catnip always falls into that category. Beautiful.
It's the underscore opus.
The opus. Wow. Okay. Opus, very cool.
Opus the Penguin from Bloom County. Wow, that came out of nowhere.
Yeah, that reminds me of a bad joke. Let's not go there.
what the fuck are you talking about? But the opus and the never.
Yeah, very cool. Yeah, beautiful song. And just, you know, those vocals just always floor me. And then Sammy.
I know those two voices like sounded
didn't they
so
sound
good.
Great together? Yes, absolutely. And then Sammy with Calling You. Just I love the video. I like how because she's getting into she gets into the song and she's you know she's kind of I just very cool video on that one especially. Very nice. What a great set with Crystal Kenneth and Sammy. Fantastic.
I know. I think Sammy Gothic Lily Doll, Sammy Gothic Lily Vampire, Sammy like left us. Where you going?
It's been a long. Anyway. It's been a long night. So if she was, it's hard for me to track.
We are a bit over.
Yeah, we're definitely over. So yeah, I could see that we might lose a couple folks. We have one amazing set left here, guys. So hang out.
Seriously, this is the last set. So last set, stick around. Yes. Check it out. Southern Yang is going to kick this off. And I'm sorry, Lex, like my program schedule's like left my screen. Oh, there it is. Okay. So.
What you looking for? I'll help you.
Lex, can you fill? There it is. Okay.
Yeah. Good luck with
Southern
this one.
Southern Yank, the kid is the name of the artist. Well, Southern Yank is the real artist. What the hell's the name of the song? That's what I need.
It's not the name of the song, Kid?
I don't know if Kid is the artist or Kid is the song.
We'll find out in a second.
No,
if you're not
Kid
kidding.
Is the name of the song. The Revivalist is the original artist. Southern Yank is the mofo who sings it. There
All
you
right.
go.
And you want to give us a front cell on our final song?
Sorry for the delay. Like and Southern Yank, great. Wait till you see like three Southern Yanks on the screen at one time with the Beard freaking Hall of Fame. He puts my scruffy shit to shame. Look at the Southern Yank growth.
Yeah.
How do you fucking grow that shit? I can't. I could let my shit grow for like 6 months. It's like, you know, like maybe like a half an inch longer. Look at Southern Yank. He looks like fucking ZZ Top. Anyway.
Are you done?
Oh my goodness. After Southern Yank.
Yes.
Our show closer.
That's what
Yoda
I'm getting.
Man and Yulia Lintu, a.k.a. Yulia Gulia.
She probably has no clue what you're talking about. I hope she's seen the movie, The Wedding Singer.
The Yoda Man, Yulia Lintu song, I don't know that I can front sell it. It's a foreign language.
Mostly,
it's
yes.
It's great. It's don't get me wrong, the video's awesome.
It's a love song,
it has to be
gorgeous video. The English translation. English translation of the title is "Close to You."
There you go.
But I will not attempt. Yoda Man was nice enough to send me a VM that tells you how to pronounce the actual title, and I still can't. I can't do it. So I'm just going to tell you up front. It's "Close to You." Well,
It is a work of art. I will
it's
say
beautiful.
That.
Beautiful.
And
yes.
A great way to close out the happy hour. So absolutely. First, Southern Yank with Kid. And I forgot the name of the original artist already, but Southern Yank
Something
sings
revivals?
It. And then, yeah, there you go. And then Yoda Man and Yulia Lintu, a.k.a. Yulia Gulia. I don't know if she knows what that means. With the foreign language song. Okay, Lex, this is, we're wrapping up the old happy hour. Whoop, whoop, yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop.
Get back, motherfucker.
Get back. This has been a great show. Thank you everyone for hanging out and hang out for the last on. Goddamn step.
Don't,
my
yes,
golly.
We got these great songs. Let's go. Can we play them?
By the way, I was down like fucking 12 points in the second quarter. Motherfucking fuck. So I'll hang out, but I hope like in the time that these two songs play.
Jonathan, you did see the show opener, right? I'm looking at his text.
Whoop, whoop.
You gotta go watch the You got to go watch the show opener again, Jonathan. All right, we'll talk later. Here we go.
All right, we are rolling.
We're going to try. Southern Yank with Kid coming up next here on the Happy Hour with Lex and Tony.
Yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop.
Get back, motherfucker.
Still fair, brave her sun's reflections in her squinting eyes, voiced her when she's laughing, I'm happy again, flexible her, she avoided all heart's trap, wash me up.
Счастье ли по колено лишь быть обнажен? lonely me.
Искрами
побежали минуты бесценные.
Золото
каждый час нам на память останется. Темной ночи потекли, в тишине родится все, что так нужно нам. Скоростью алая быть с тобой рядом целый век мало мне. Как волны скрывают след. Расскажи, и разреженный воздух наполнит звук.
Растворен
я в тебе, растворен, меня больше нет.
Сохрани
на твоих одинаковый сердце стук. Каждый раз разрезать нетерпением облака. Третий рим, город грез, я опять невменяемый. Пилигрим, что за тайны тревожит твоя рука. Темной ночи потекли. Алая, быть с тобой рядом целый век мало мне. Скоростью, алая, быть с тобой рядом целый век мало мне.
Dangerous mountain ridge, scarlet star to escape from my fate. A whole century with you is not enough for me. Not enough for me. Century with you is not enough for me.
Hey guys, welcome back to Happy Hour with Lex and Tony. And you know, I tell you, we haven't had, I mean, every set tonight has been fabulous. We kicked this last set off with Southern Yank. I think it was three Southern Yanks doing Kid. And I tell you, you know, Southern Yank, Carl, is so good. He's great on video. He's very comfortable on video. But I absolutely love, you know, when he does these self-collabs and he, you know, I guess it makes sense, right? You're going to blend better with your own voice than anybody else's. But he gets it, like, just right. He the harms are perfect, the volumes, the effects he chooses. It all ties together so well. He's just great like that. So I always love sharing his stuff.
You're right. Like, Southern Yank knows what's going on video.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's very good with the video.
He has mastered that.
Yeah.
And, you know, and quite frankly, like, we debuted the Beard Hall of Fame.
Oh, that's right.
Southern Yankee, he's like the fucking Babe Ruth and Ty Cobb of the Beard Hall of Fame, because that shit is like wow. It's like inaugural, like I don't even know how to say it. Like it's so good. Like
it's good. It's good.
My own little scruffy beard feels like I feel like I'm
Nick
Keller.
Consider that a beard so much, even though I guess it would. It's more like scruff than a beard. I don't know. I don't think it even counts.
Do you know who Mick Kelleher and Davey Rosello are?
I do not. Lex? Are you shocked?
They were like pieces of shit that played for the Cubs in like the mid 70s. And that's what my beard looks like compared to Southern Yank, who's like the Babe Ruth Ty Cobb of beards in the Beard Hall of Fame. I'm like Davey Rosello. But that's okay.
All right.
You know what? Like his hair follicles have a higher whatever than mine, but that's okay. But apart from that, Southern Yank sounds fucking great every goddamn time he sings.
He does. He really does.
Like, seriously, he brings it. He is a performer.
You know, that's exactly right. That's exactly right. He knows how to perform. Yeah.
Seriously. I mean, it's so effortless when he like, but you know, I know he pours his heart into it, but
he does.
It just, he's just so smooth. Way to go, Carl.
There you go. And Yoda Man and Yulia Linto. Holy cow. So, you know, what a beautiful song. And then,
I don't mean to like gush on Southern Yank. Yoda Man and Yulia Gulia, they're singing in Russian? What the fuck? That was awesome.
Beautiful song. Yeah, and that's awesome. That's no easy task for Yoda Man to jump into that. That's definitely a labor of love, if you will. Beautifully done. The video was lovely. It was very cool to have the English lyrics for reference alongside the fantastic video of the two of you singing together. Really nicely done.
Where were the English lyrics? I saw like backwards R's and stuff.
So I on the left-hand side, so on the right-hand side, you had the two of them. You could see Yoda Man and Yulia. On the left-hand side of the screen, at the top, there was the lyrics in Russian, but below it were the English translation. So you could get a better feel for the song and what they were singing about. Very nicely done.
That was a beautiful song. Like a lovely,
right?
Beautiful song. And Yoda Man and Yulia Lintu, not Yulia Gulia. It sounded perfect on that.
It did.
Great song.
The two of them sound great together. They really do. Now, before we close out the show, Frank Michael made a very important point in the chat just now. You know what? In 3 days' time, we have an eclipse coming up that folks should be aware of. They're probably aware of it already. If you're in the path of the eclipse and you can watch it, be careful how you watch it. Make sure that you're using, eye protection and all that, whether it's the special glasses or the shoebox approach, which is what I do because I don't have any special glasses. Be careful with that so you don't accidentally burn your retinas or, hurt your eyes. I think someone had mentioned, I believe it's true. I didn't fact check it, but, if you videotape it on your phone and then if you watch it on the phone, it could also be dangerous. So
it'll fuck up your phone. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't mess around with that. Just be sure you're careful. And the most important thing that we need to remind you of, it's not a good day to buy unusual plants. And if you don't know why we're saying that, wait till next week when you see Little Shop of Horrors. I hope you guys are familiar with the show.
Whoop, whoop. Don't buy no plants.
Because
come April 12th, we got Little Shop of Horror.
At least, I was going to say, at least next week, I don't have a complicated song to do with you, but we do have our own complicated song, which... For the record, we haven't even had a chance to start
that.
Yet,
I know.
Or part out or anything. So, Tony, we need to talk about that when we get off the air here. You guys, thank you so much for those of you who are getting involved with the Little Shop of Horrors special for next week. Thank you so much. We love what you're doing. We're very excited to see what you're creating. If you need help from us, definitely reach out and let us know. If you are listening to the show tonight and you want to get involved, we have two songs that have a very large like company part where like everyone sings. If you'd like to get involved and you haven't already, and we had at least one person reach out to me this evening to do just that. If you'd like to get involved in those songs, you can jump in and sing the alls. It'll be so much fun to have you involved. So if you're new, any interest at all, just reach out to me online or, you know, on Twitch or YouTube, however you can reach out to me or Tony, and we will get you involved for the show next Friday. So it's going to be a blast.
There you go. It will be fun.
Yes, absolutely.
Lex, all I got to say is yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop. Caitlin Carr dropping threes. Let's go, Iowa. Beat UConn. I can't rhyme it, but whatever. Get back, motherfucker. You don't know me like that. Get back, Paige Beckers. You don't know me like that.
There you go.
Yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop. Anyway, great show.
So much good music. You guys totally rocked it.
I love this show tonight. So much diversity.
Yes.
Everything was like, oh, my God. But anyway, I'm going to go watch your basketball. Watch the Hawks, yes. The Lady Hawks. Let's go, Caitlin Clark. We will join you next week, Little Shop of Horrors musical. It's going to be a blast.
Yep.
Yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop. There we go. All right, Lex, I'm done.
Back, Tony. We'll see you next week, everyone, for tuning in.
Yeet, yeet, whoop, whoop. There we go. All
right. Have a good one, guys. See you next Friday.
To alcohol, the cause of and solution to all of life's problems.
Closing time, open all the doors and let you out into the world.
So long, partner.
You met me at a very strange time in my life.
I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
I said it before and I'll say it again. Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.